Hi everybody, this is Jennifer with Choice Backgrounds, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to use all of the video overlays. This process works for every single kind of overlay. I'm going to be using some overlays from the Wedding Bundle 2 overlays, so that's why I have a nice wedding picture happening here. But the process, this is the same for all of them. So first thing I'm going to do is just drag a photo into a slide. I'll double click on it to come into my slide options window. Then I'll just hit the plus button to come and find my video files, add image or video. And now you've got to know where you've got your files. I downloaded and unzipped to my Choice Backgrounds folder, Wedding Bundle 2, NTSC Overlays. Now for each of these overlays, you will have two files and you need them both. Okay, I'm going to be using this GH overlay. GH stands for glass heart, by the way. Now I'm going to need both the color version and this white version. You'll see in the name there, it's the same name, but it has alpha on the end. Video files, when you can see through the black to something underneath, is utilizing its alpha channel. Now at this time, ProShow cannot see the alpha channel in video files the way it can in still files, such as PNGs and PSDs. You just drop those in and it can see right through. With a video file, you need to have this extra layer and set it as a mask. So first we'll bring in the color layer. I'm just gonna double click on it and it'll bring it in. Then I need to go back and bring in the masking layer. Now, if you have downloaded all these, don't forget there are two versions. There's a wide screen that's 16:9 and there's also a 4:3. Don't accidentally mix and match those, okay? If you're in a wide screen, bring in both of these for the wide screen. Now, using widescreen videos in a widescreen show sounds like it should work automatically. Unfortunately, there's a little bug in Producer. If you come into Layers, Layer Settings, for these video files, even though they were rendered at widescreen, you're in a widescreen show, all of these aspect ratios will default to 4:3. So I'm afraid if you're working in a 16:9, for each of these video files, you have to come and manually change them to 16:9. That looks much better. Okay, and make sure you do it for both. Okay, you've got to make sure that both the mask and the color video file are set to 16:9. Now, if I just play this the way it is, I see nothing but a black heart and white. If I turn that off and see the color layer, I see my color, but I don't see my image beneath it. In order to make that happen, make sure your mask is on and highlighted. This over here, masking layer, make sure you check this for that top layer. You'll see how this next one was kind of scooted underneath. What this does is it kind of works like a stencil. So what it's doing is it's going to erase all this white so you can see the red and then punch a hole through the black. So you can see your image underneath. So now when I hit play, I get my nice color. I've just punched a hole through the black and I can see my photo underneath, which is great. Now it's not aligned correctly, so I'm gonna go into my effects tab, highlight my photo, and I'm just gonna move it over. Now this preview is completely wrong. Again, kind of a bug in Producer. This is showing the photo on the side, but if you look at my preview, it's not there. Gonna kinda have to work with us on this one. There's still a few bugs in Producer when it comes to video files, but so make sure you just have this aligned right. And if you're not sure if it looks quite right, double check over here. I'm gonna make sure that those are lined up real good. And I'm gonna make sure that my people are not getting totally cut off by that heart. And I'm going to increase their size to 120 at the end and bring them down a little bit. Okay, and let's hit play right here and see what we've got. That looks all right, but my people are kind of being cut off by the heart. So actually, I'm going to start at about 140 so that I don't have to worry about this heart, you know, cutting off their faces. And then I'm going to go up to 160 and just realign the end. Okay, and hit OK. And hit play. And there we have it. It's not quite lined up right again. This is just kind of a bug in Producer. You can see it fills the whole screen here in the preview. But it doesn't work that way here. So I'm just going to move this over, even though it doesn't look right at all. But it will look right here. Okay. I apologize for this. Hopefully Photodex will fix this soon. So now I've got my people lined up just right. Everything's filling the screen. Now you can change your slide time. That was pretty quick. You can change this to 8 seconds and play. And now I've got my people behind my mask. Okay. Now there are some other masks. Let me go over really quickly that I actually did not give you an alpha channel for, and that's because they are all white anyway. So I'm going to bring in some of my sparkles. Here's the sparkle bundle. These do not have overlays. Let's see. I'm just going to grab this sparkle wipe down. And there's no need to have an alpha file with this because alphas are all white and black anyway. But you still need to create a mask out of it. If I drop a photo in underneath, even though I didn't include an alpha channel, if you play this back, you still can't see your person underneath, okay? So this one still needs to be a mask, but you can make it a mask over anything you want. That's what's pretty cool about this. If I come back into my Layers tab, I can hit this plus button and add a solid color or a gradient. I can even add a photo underneath. So let's do each one of these and show you what happens. Let's add a solid color. Let's say we want it to be white. We just want white sparkles. We'll bring that underneath my sparkle white down, highlight that layer, and hit this layer's a mask. Don't forget with this, you really do want to change that to 16 by 9. So now when I play this back, I get sparkles over my picture. And they're white sparkles, okay? You could make it a gradient. Let's get rid of this one. And we're going to add a gradient. Let's just add something kind of fun. We'll just add this orange and red one, orange one. Okay? Again, highlight that. Make it a mask. Now when we see the sparkles, they're all orange and red. Okay? So if you've ordered any of these sparkles, basically all you've got was the mask because that's all you needed. You could even use a photograph underneath this. Let's add this rose with the wedding rings, and we're going to put it underneath the sparkles. I'm going to check that as a mask. And now when we play it back, the sparkles are actually, they kind of give you that impression of the ring. So that could be a really cool effect too. So those are the two ways that you can use these overlays. If you have a color video file, you also have an alpha. Make sure you use them together. If you have a plain white video file, such as the sparkles, you don't need any other video file. Just add a color, a gradient, or a photo underneath, and you're good to go. Just make sure you check those white and black layers, either the alpha or the sparkles, as a mask, and you're good to go. Thanks so much for watching.